Okay, so while I'm in here, I just want to reflect over a dream that I had a few days back. And for some reason in my dreams, I keep seeing homosexual stuff. And I think it's reflecting the spirit over the land. And I know we have to be prayed up. The devil comes in to deceive. The devil tries to send spirits of lust. And I get all that. So I, as a young lady, have to stay prayed up. I am in no way, shape, or form gay. I am straight, waiting on my husband from God. A big, strong, manly man that is gifted in every area so that he can bless my soul and my body, if you know what I mean, when the Lord calls us to come together to be one. So don't get it twisted. But this last dream I had, I was talking to a prophet in the dream. I was talking to him real quick, and then it switched scenes. And what I saw were these pretty black young ladies. And it was like they were doing choreography for a video. And so first they were all kind of lined up together, and then all of a sudden, like, it was like they were doing choreography video. The like girls came from the side of the other girls and kneeled down in front of the other girls and began to perform oral abomination with them. And then the girls that were like still standing up, like, kind of poked out their bottom to the girls so they can do this oral abominating act. And I looked over to them and I said, "Repent." They said, "What?" They started getting mad. They started walking up to me. I said, "Repent." I said, "I'm not scared of you." And I think I just, you know, was trying to tell them to repent. That's my whole thing. I feel like I have the spirit of a prophetess, almost like, I'm not no way, shape, form the John the Baptist, but almost one of those hearts of John the Baptist is telling the people to repent. We're in the last days. And they were like, what? They got all mad. They started coming to me, and I said, "I'm not scared of you." And I don't remember what else, but I'm sure I was telling them to repent, and it switched scenes again. I just want to tell y'all young folks, it might look good, it might feel good to the body, but it is hell bound. I know God delivered me. He delivered me from lust. I've said many times I could have been gay. I thank God he didn't let me go that way. I would have been the worst of the worst, because I'm a passionate person. So whatever I love, I'm passionate about, I'm going to ride or die for that. So I thank God for giving me a saved mother that raised me up in holiness. And she would tell me when I was into these dead celebrities, "You better take them off your wall. They in hell. If they could tell you, they would tell you to get right with God." And I tell people that. And I was depressed for a while. I was obsessed with Tupac, Aaliyah, Selena, all these people, but really Tupac and Aaliyah. But God delivered me, and this cloud just lifted over my head. And these people were chosen. And when you're chosen and you don't serve God, the wrath of God comes upon you. Thus Aaliyah, thus that singer that had that pretty voice back in the 70s, Sam Cooke, plane crash, Aaliyah, plane crash. Some of these people don't know God. It's a blessing to grow up in the Word of God, to learn holiness, because you have no excuse. You don't know, you know better. These other people don't really know better like that, but God is, I believe that God sent people their way. He'll get your attention and let you know, "Hey, I didn't call you to sing secular, or if you start, come to me. I called you to use your beauty and your gift for me, not for hell, not for homosexuality, not for Black Lives Matter, not for gay pride," because the statement is true, but these movements are demonic. Black Lives Matter, I saw them break it down. Love is love. No, love is defined as God defines it, between a man and a woman, being fruitful and multiplying. He defined it as a man and a woman. That's what it is. So I want to encourage you young folks, if you're struggling with homosexuality, God can deliver you. I was struggling with lust, just with myself, and that could have led to homosexuality. I even went through a phase where I was wearing baggy pants, Aaliyah, TLC, and I was dope. I was cute. Like, I was old school 90s. That was like my 11th grade year. I had a picture of it, but I deleted it. But God got my attention one day, and I told this on my Facebook, and blood came through on my pants. I was in chemistry. I was in some class, and they was like, "Oh," I bent over, and blood came through, and I went to the bathroom. They said, "Go to the bathroom." I went to the bathroom, and I knew that God was telling me, I don't like you wearing these baggy pants. I don't like this style. God, I believe that God called me to be an elegant young lady, not to dress boyish. Like, I can wear pants and be a lady. Thus, boom, got on my skinny jeans. Okay, I need to lose about 10 pounds. Don't judge me. But I was wearing baggy pants. I was going through my TLC Aaliyah stage. That can lead to being a dyke, a bulldogger. I'm old school. A woman acting like a man. So God saved me from, he saved me from what I could have been. And I listened. I said, "Mom, I should have been wearing them baggy pants." She was like, "I told you that." And I went to wearing skinny jeans and skirts. And I believe that God called me to represent a young lady. I love wearing beautiful dresses. I like wearing them elegant. Like I told y'all, the angel came to me, said, "When you go to church, just make sure your dress is just at least beneath your knees." And that's all he said. I knew he meant to be in decency and order, not showing skin. I took it a step further. I said, look, I'm just going to be safe. And I just like, and I took it. I said, let me just wear floral knit. I just started hating showing my legs in church. And then period, anyway, for that matter. And I used to love being sexy, showing my legs as I got older. But the split up the dress. I told you I was old school 90s. I'm a 90s baby. When I got older, I started dressing like the 90s. But I'm just very elegant. So I took it a step further for me. You don't have to have it all the way down to your knees. Ain't no religion. But that's just what I like. That I feel like God gave me a very elegant style. And I just like, let me be safe. Let me be in decency and order. And just old school holiness. Let me be modest. But you don't have to have it down to your ankles. As long as it's at least underneath your knees. Just be modest when you keep in mind to fear God. And don't cause anything to distract when you're in church. You don't have to be showing your thighs and all your cleavage. Say that for your husband, a future husband. Ladies, you don't have to do the most to be sexy. We're not coming to church to be sexy. If you fine and built wine, you can't help that. But you can dress modest with it. So let's remember that. But I come to tell the young people and everybody, come out of homosexuality, fornication, abomination, abortion, adultery. God sees it. Don't play with God. And if you're struggling, you feel like, oh, well, I'm going to hell anyway. No. He can save you. He can deliver you. I would have been the worst of the worst. But God saw fit to save me before I even got to that point. And he can save you even if you're at the point. Saul was the worst of the worst.